30 seconds.
Jeez, please, the time goes.
Yep. Next thing you know, it'll be 4:50. So dang, so we gotta get you more radio then, if that's the case, right?
Well, I've been contemplating.
No,
obviously. There's been some opportunities. It's like I'm covering the Drew Brees Foundation event on the 1st.
Nice. Yeah, I mean, there's tons going on right now. It's
you don't do video, do you?
Not really. I can put you to some people, though. All right. You don't need headphones? Or? Oh, you got it.
Woo! Welcome to Vegas Sports Girl. Happy Tuesday. This is Tanja Brennan. Hope you're having a great week so far and staying out of that dang wind. My hair ain't working here. Joining me, my special guest. You know him, you love him. Ron Futrell is here. How are you, bud?
They call me the Breeze tonight.
The Breeze?
I'm going to be the Breeze. There's a Lynyrd Skynyrd song with it. Call me the Breeze.
Yeah.
Keep rolling down the door. So, anyway, I won't try to recreate it, but how am I doing? I'm doing well, thank you. Much better now that I'm here hanging with you. How about that?
I love it. I was getting kind of worried because it was getting close to the hour and you weren't quite here yet, but that's okay. It's Ron time. You can come in fashionably late,
well,
right?
Well, I have at times. I don't intend to. It's part of the sort of this other job at Channel 8
that
gets in the way of radio sometimes, but I never mind coming in just like right on time.
Keeping you on your edge.
Timing myself out.
Right. Speaking of fashionably late, you look like you're going to go out in the woods today or hiking. That's a new look. I like it.
I've got the Pikes Peak corduroy shirt on with the sleeves rolled up and the jeans. And if I need to go up to Red Rock and do a little bit of hiking up there, yeah, this would be the day to do it. It might get you out of the wind a little bit because you'll be shielded by the mountains.
That's crazy. This wind is nuts here in Las Vegas.
Yes.
So this weekend, I went to NOLA, New Orleans, Louisiana.
Oh.
Had a special party. And I got to tell you what, that city never sleeps. That's all I'm going
to
say.
I went there in 87 with UNLV when they went to the NCAA tournament, the Final Four back there. And I remember going there and thinking, okay, Vegas. Well, I'm from Vegas, so I'm used to some stuff going on and happening. I thought, wait a second, we got nothing on New Orleans. Like, they are over the top. Craziness,
wild,
never seen. We need an area sort of like Bourbon Street.
Yes.
I don't know. The Strip, they Bourbon Street. We need sight, sounds, music,
art,
food,
yep.
in a small little condensed area. That's cool. Downtown, I think, is trying to be part
sort
of that
right.
a little bit.
I don't know. New Orleans is pretty unique. I know every time I go there, we went to Commander's Palace for the party, so they know how to do it right. You know, food and
right.
Liquor and wine and vodka. I mean, that's just New Orleans. So then you come back and you just have to kind of cleanse a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
But it's a fun town.
Thaw out a little bit from all the wetness. And I'm not talking about flooding. Yes, it is a fun place. I have some great memories there when the Rebels lost to Indiana in the first round of the Final Four,
mm-hmm.
the NCAA Final Four back there. Indiana went on to win the national championship. Again, this was 87. Steve Alford just raining threes down on top of the Rebels. And that was a very good Rebel team. That was a Rebel team that went 36-2 until that point. 37-1 because they lost. They ended the season 37-2. 37-2, pretty good record.
That's a pretty dang good record.
For a basketball
yep.
team, they were number one many times throughout the season, but they had the late, great Armand Gilliam in the middle on that team. Gerald Patio was hitting three-pointers. Fearless Freddie Banks was all over the place with threes. Gary Graham was there, just a youngster on that team. So Eldridge Hudson on that. It was a fun it was a fun basketball team that lost too early, and only because Steve Alford, and that was the Bobby Knight Indiana Hoosiers.
Sure.
Steve Alford went nuts with double, triple screens and hit three-pointers like crazy. So That being said, but the other stuff around New Orleans, that was, yeah, that was a little crazy. I thought I'd seen a lot of stuff here in Vegas. No, then I went to New Orleans and it was
crazy,
over the top.
Right?
Yes.
You have to do a gator boat ride. That's pretty fascinating.
I didn't do
as
that.
Well.
Yeah, okay. But
anyway.
Yeah.
And you saw the Pelicans. They got the number one draft pick in the NBA this year.
What a waste.
I was shocked that they got the draft pick.
Yeah, they certainly weren't the favorites to be
right.
able to do that. They had a very slim chance of getting that pick, but it shows you this. If anybody wanted to accuse the NBA of rigging the draft, it shows their draft is not rigged, okay, because the top two picks, and there are two very good players in this draft, going to New Orleans,
mm-hmm.
going to the Pelicans, and then the Memphis Grizzlies, and then from there it goes, you know, it goes Knicks and Lakers.
So where do you think Mr. Zion will go?
It's done.
He's got to go number one.
There's no question about
regardless.
That.
Regardless.
He's one, and he'll be down there with Anthony Davis. The Pelicans owner basically said, there is no way in hell we're trading Anthony Davis. Okay, AD's going nowhere. Now, he's a free agent after this season. It might
mm-hmm.
be best for him to go somewhere. But at the same time, maybe if that team can succeed down there, Anthony Davis would want to stay in New Orleans with Zion. Now, Vegas fits into this mix a little bit too, because
tell me how.
As there have been a lot of rumors about Vegas getting an NBA team.
Yes.
There's no shock to anybody.
Lots of rumors.
For a lot of reasons. First of all, you got T-Mobile Arena. You have the tremendous success of the Golden Knights. You have the Raiders coming here after next season. And the NBA has, and we have the WNBA here, and that's usually a precursor to if you
mm-hmm.
take a WNBA team, you might get an NBA team as well. That's not unheard of. So, all that being said, the NBA has to look at Las Vegas and say, wait a second, we're missing the boat. Every day we're not in Vegas, we're missing out on something, and the NHL is getting something, and they're direct competitors. They're right up against each other throughout the regular season and their playoffs. So, that being said, New Orleans has been one of the prominent teams that's been mentioned as a possible team to leave there and come here. Memphis has been
interesting.
I wouldn't mind seeing the Clippers come here, but I don't think that's happening with the success they're having
yeah.
in LA right now.
Yeah. It's going to be interesting. It doesn't surprise me at all. I think it's just around the corner.
It's got to happen. It will happen. I've said for a while I might back off this prediction now, but I have said quite a few times that I thought the NBA would make an announcement before the Raiders get here. That clock is ticking, so that would give them about
a year. About 6 months?
No, a year
seven
and a half.
Months.
Before the
oh,
Raiders
yeah,
get here.
Before the Raiders get here. Got it.
Before the Raiders play
yes.
their first game here is what I'm
okay.
where I was going with that. So we're 6 months, we're a year and a half away from the Raiders playing their first game here in Las Vegas. So I don't know. Now at this point, I'm backing off that one a little bit and going, I'm not sure, but they will come here. They
we
will
shall see.
Yeah.
We shall see. Very exciting. So speaking of the NBA, the Golden State Warriors do it again. Not surprised. I mean, last night they played game four against the Portland Trail Blazers in a nail-biter game, OT. And
yes.
one basket. There you go. The Warriors are going to their championship game again. Steph Curry, actually 37 points. So he had a triple-double. 37 points in overtime, 13 rebounds, and 11 assists. Only one other player in years past has beat him with 39 points in the championships. Do you know who that is?
Well, 39 in a Western Conference championship?
Actually, it was an Eastern Conference.
It was an Eastern Conference championship.
Yeah.
Oh, a little clue there. Larry Bird?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
Ding, ding. Yep.
Ding, ding, ding. What do I win?
Very exciting.
Was that the trivia? There, I get
yeah.
it, sure. Was that the
get.
Trivia question you were
no.
going to ask me, or did I have some other ones?
We're going to have a little fun with trivia in just a few minutes. But anyways, I'm going to put you on the spot. Coach Steve Kerr, this is his fifth straight championship appearance, and this is their fifth straight four-game sweep in the playoffs. So it's going to be really interesting because now they're moving on, and tonight is a big game.
Yes.
The Bucks and Toronto Raptors in Toronto at 5:30. The Bucks lead the series 2-1. What are you thinking tonight?
Well, they're gonna. I would play the Bucks. The Bucks are favored to win this game tonight in Toronto. Oddly enough, the game on Sunday went two overtimes, and Kawhi Leonard is just he's just such a fun player to watch, and those of us that watched him closely here when he was at San Diego State going up against UNLV, because they played here quite a bit in the conference tournament. So I never saw this in him. I thought he could make it the NBA and be a fringe player.
Sure.
Boy, but not a superstar. He is a superstar and fun to watch. But Milwaukee's got the Greek freak, and he keeps going strong, Giannis. And I think Milwaukee wins today and closes out Milwaukee. They want to get this thing done. They want to be able to rest up for Golden State. They don't want Golden State to get too much rest and get Kevin Durant. You've heard of him before?
I've heard, and yet he's been non-existent, obviously, but he will be healthy, I'm going to guess, for the championship
games. He should
be.
Yes.
So what happens should the Bucks win tonight? When do they play next?
Thursday or Friday, this week. Yes, it is scheduled, so I'm going to check it out on my phone.
But we shall see.
It would be, it's interesting, hockey goes every other day, like it's religion, and basketball, sometimes when they travel, they will make it 3 days.
It'll be Thursday.
It's Thursday,
it's
a 2-day break. Thank you.
He's good.
Oh, he's on the ball.
He's on the ball, man. So that's what I mean.
Pun intended.
Hey. I love it. Other NBA news, Timberwolves will re-sign Ryan Saunders as head coach, and Tim Connelly is staying with the Nuggets. Interesting with coaches. So, Ron, got some trivia for you.
Oh, okay.
You're a Lakers fan, right? I mean, I'm not giving you any clues or answers,
right,
but
okay.
I'm going to throw some questions at you. Don't look at my cheat sheet. Okay. Other than the Warriors, which team was the only team to reach 5 straight NBA finals?
Boston Celtics.
Very good. Very nice.
We
have 7. I'm going to roll through these.
Say Lakers fan. Remember, I'm not a fan because I can't be. I'm a journalist, so I have to be unbiased.
I know. But I grew up
in L.A. loving the Lakers, and it's been a painful 6 years for me with them not making the playoffs.
But you know your stuff. Which team was the last team to do a three-peat as champions in the early 2000s?
Bulls?
Oh, my gosh, Ron.
I mean, it's Chicago Bulls. Lakers?
Yes,
Lakers
is your team.
Lakers did it after that. It's 2000, 2001, 2002.
And who was their coach? Do you remember? Pat Riley.
You're telling me.
I just gave you the answer.
That was Shaq Kobe. Yeah, that's right. Bulls did it twice before then. Bulls had an eight-year span where they won six, eight. And then Jordan went to play baseball for 2 years, and San Antonio won in those 2 years. Or Houston, it was some Texas team. And then the Bulls came back and won 3 straight again once Jordan returned. So you're right, of course. The Lakers since then was 2000.
You're 50-50, Ron.
That shot again. 50-50. No, that one makes me mad because I knew. Is this Jeopardy?
You
am
knew
I
this.
Getting,
yes,
be
it's
James
Jeopardy.
Holt,
this is
James
Vegas
Holtower?
Sports Girl Jeopardy. Here we go.
Okay.
This player retired and had played more games than any other player, won 3 rings as part of the Boston Big 3 in the 80s. And he also scored 20,000 career points. Who is this?
Who is Larry Bird?
Robert Parrish.
Robert Parrish, the Chief.
It's been a while since I've heard. I mean, Robert Parrish is.
Yeah.
He played over 1,600 games in over 21 seasons.
I remember when he got in trouble for smoking some marijuana and got caught. And so it became. I remember using the line on there. I thought it was so clever that it was a chief, because that was his nickname.
Yeah.
With his peace pipe, with a smoke pipe, and the chief was smoking it.
A little bit of history for you. There you go.
Yeah.
Now, this isn't easy. This is a gimme. Everyone in this room should know this. What's Dr. J's real name?
Julius Erving.
Duh. Yes, Julius Erving.
The grand old.
I'm getting dinged for that one.
I had to give you an easy one, Mom. We need to get you up here on the, on the higher percentage here. All right, the great Michael Jordan averaged 41 points per game in an NBA Finals series. Which NBA team did he go against?
Maybe it was Detroit, but because they did play Detroit twice. How about the finals. It's in the finals.
The finals.
Okay, so it's the finals. So Detroit would have been in the
I know
Eastern.
You know this. You're being a good sport.
No, hold on. Is it the Lakers? Portland?
I love
Houston?
That about Ron. Everything's Lakers. Phoenix Suns.
Phoenix Suns.
Yep.
Oh, I forgot the Thunder Dan Marley team. But
Can
the Suns and,
yep.
Okay.
Charles Barkley. He played the Suns and Charles Barkley. This was in 1993. And the Bulls won in 6 games. Interesting, right?
Okay.
I just thought this was fascinating as we were talking NBA. So, all right, lastly.
Utah Jazz.
No. What? This is your team.
Okay.
Lakers trivia. What was the 2008 Lakers franchise called in 1946?
Minneapolis Lakers?
The Detroit Gems.
No.
Wait a minute, wait.
No, they were not
Detroit Gems. This was
the
year
Lakers?
The Lakers were founded. Their owner in 1946 was C. King Coring.
That was all about the
Midwest. I would have never, you're right.
I was with you on that one.
Yeah.
George Mikan, right?
And hold
yeah,
on. This is something else that's pretty interesting.
That's why they're the Lakers.
Right. In 1946, they posted a league worst record. You ready for this? 4-40. Similar to how they're doing today.
not too far.
Interesting. You did good though, Ron.
No, but it is interesting team names, and I like this. I remember sitting down talking to somebody who didn't know team names and why teams were named certain things.
Makes sense.
Because you look at the Lakers, and there's not lakes in L.A. I mean,
right.
Lake Elsinore, what does that count? The Salton Sea, how many lakes are there that you don't?
We learned something,
Griffith
right,
Reservoir.
Ron?
They're the Lakers because they were in Minneapolis. The Jazz are an interesting one.
Yes.
Utah Jazz.
Didn't they come from New Orleans?
Well, they did.
Yes.
Sam Battistone, who lives here in Henderson, moved them from New Orleans. Pistol Pete Maravich played for the New Orleans Jazz then. Moved them to Salt Lake City. They kept the name Jazz,
mm-hmm.
which made a lot of people in New Orleans angry because, I don't know if you know, Salt Lake City, and I've lived there. I lived there 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
Not really known for its Jazz.
Exactly.
He wanted to keep that franchise name, which he did. And there's still a lot of people, I'm one of them, that say they just take the Jazz and put them back in New Orleans
right.
and let Salt Lake be the Bees, Bumblebee, Beehives, or the Beehive State.
Sure.
Something else, you know.
I agree.
Salt Lakes. No, that doesn't fit. Hold on, we can keep something nice.
So, Ron, you did great. By the way, thank you for playing. I just thought I'd throw you off a little bit with the NBA. Big game tonight, so we shall see what happens moving forward.
Yeah, this will be fun, and I'm going with Milwaukee tonight to be able to win this one and take control of this series
mm-hmm.
and eventually win out in Milwaukee. And it'll be a fun final. I like Milwaukee in a matchup against Golden State. Now, again, with or without Kevin Durant, still not sure with that. That is a variable. But I still like the one.
But all the naysayers, they've been proven wrong. They can still win without KD.
Yeah,
as we've seen it.
They're
so.
20. They're 26-1 without him, by the way. So
okay.
I wasn't one of those naysayers that thought they couldn't win without Kevin Durant. I think what happens is other, not me. I
not
wasn't
you.
A naysayer.
Yeah.
Other guys step up and go at it, and they're fun to watch. I like Kevin Durant, so it's fun to watch with him. By the way, Kevin Durant needs to leave and go to the Lakers next year. Anybody
no.
with me on that one? Anybody?
Congrats
anybody?
To the Warriors. That's my basketball team.
He's a free agent. He's a free agent.
So,
everybody.
Thank you for playing, Ron.
Thank you.
Anyway, I want to thank our sponsors, Finley Volvo and the Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Check us out on VegasSportsGirl.com. We have a lot of sports and entertainment, and we have Aviator. It's coming up at the end of the hour, so I'm excited about that. We'll be back in just a few minutes. It's kind of fun. Thanks for playing.
You get nothing as a prize.
I like doing that kind of stuff.
It's
just saying a little different.
Dodgers at Tampa Bay. Kershaw. LA Dodgers are -145. Tampa Bay is pretty good.
That was really good, Ari. Oh,
thanks. I was looking for, we didn't have the buzzer. We had the ding
and
the
awesome.
Buzzer, so I did no soup for you.
I love trivia. I was actually at my desk today, and my assistant, we were chatting about basketball, and I was like, look at these facts, like just old facts. I was like, what? Lakers were named the Gems?
Yeah, I had no idea. That's why I wouldn't,
insane.
When it comes to sports knowledge, I'm not definitely not the authority, but that's why I was like, no, hold on a minute.
I would have never guessed that.
Yeah.
Like, I read that over and went.
And the Robert Parrish one I did have, too.
Yeah,
but,
did you?
Yeah, I did, but I wasn't going to interrupt
that
anything.
Too, sure.
And then I also wasn't sure. Oh, thanks. We had Coach Otts. I wasn't currently for it, but we had the new head coach from,
yeah.
Is that how you say it, Otts? Otts. So they were like, where are you in LV? Or, that's how I rolled.
That was fun. What do you think, Michael? You doing okay, bud?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
So, yep.
So we'll go.
It's weird. I got another way there.
Oh, you said 440, not 30, right?
440.
Okay.
So we'll go into this. Let's talk Let's talk some hockey news. Cool beans? There's really a lot of stuff going on in the NFL right now, too. But we'll talk hockey, and if we have time going into... Because I want to lead in to Jim. You know, Jim. Yeah, baseball stuff. If I need to move football down to the end, I will.
All right, come back.
Did we sign any of our hockey free? Did we all of our?
Colin, no, nothing official. I did hear that Colin Miller that they're possible. There's like rumors floating around that they might just for cap room, which I'm not a fan of that move.
He's the defenseman to go if they need cap room. I don't know what his salary is.
There we go. Ready?
I was born ready, Ari. Ari just asked me if I was ready. I was born ready. And let me tell you something. Your music rocks, my friend.
Thank you.
No pun intended.
I didn't think of Ari. I think of coming up Indy 500 this weekend, by the way. And I always think of Ari Landa.
Landa, yeah.
Great racer out of Phoenix. Is where he lives most recently. And his son, Ari Landa Jr., is also racing. But Ari and I have done a lot of stuff together over the years. And I remember him winning the Indy 500. I was there. Remember him coming here to Vegas and racing quite often. I've done quite a few interviews with him. Flew on a flight with him one time to and from Indy. But so anyway, fun guy, great guy. So Ari, there you go, your namesake. I think of Indy 500 this weekend.
Back in the day, when I was a kid, there weren't Aris around, so that was one of the few. And I had no idea who that. I'd be like, oh, like Ari Lyons, that's right. And then over the years, it kind of there was a couple other. And then once Ari Gold came around from the Entourage, all of a sudden everybody's named Ari. Now it's not even it's common now. So.
But you weren't named after him. It just happens to be.
No, it's my full name's Ariel. It's Hebrew, actually. It means lion, believe it or not.
Very cool. You're a lion. Yeah.
As you can see.
He's a very nice guy, Ari Lyons.
I've heard good things.
So, yes, that part's cool.
It's a good name.
Here's what I'm looking for real quick, and I won't talk a lot of motorsports here. But
I do want to talk about it.
I
want to ask you, did you watch the races this past weekend? Did you watch any of the races?
NASCAR? I did not watch NASCAR. No, I did. I watched qualifying for the Indy. I do like that NBC is taking over the broadcast this year for the first time in 30 or 40 years. Mm-hmm. ABC has done it forever. So I'm looking forward to them putting a different touch onto it that will spice things up a little bit. Mm-hmm. So. Notice if the Indy 500 looks a little different this year, it's because it's switching networks. And every once in a while, that's good, I think, for a sport to do that.
Sure.
To shake it up and have somebody else take a different look at it. Like, let's go here. Fox has always had the UFC. They've done a great job with the UFC. Now it's on ESPN, and ESPN is putting their spin to it and their mm-hmm. take to it and stuff. So I don't mind these sort of switches every once in a while to shake things up, give a different look. Okay, so
speaking of ESPN, can we touch upon something?
Oh, no.
President Jimmy Pitaro, did you hear this? Made an announcement today that he said ESPN is not going to talk politics.
Bless him.
That is, thank you, right? Like, when I watch ESPN, I just want to watch dang sports. Why do I need to hear about the political side of things?
He has jacked up ESPN with his politics. And by the way, it's politics on one side. Mm-hmm. It's one politics in one direction. It's politics to the left. Mm-hmm. ESPN politics to the right does not fit with their format.
Absolutely.
And ask Kurt Schilling. And I can give you that story. Very good, very close. I know a lot of details about it, more than I should. But their politics, yes, their politics are absolutely to the left. And they should be in neither direction when you're talking sports. They should mm-hmm. be in neither direction. Mm-hmm. And it's turned viewers off. It's turned me off. It's turned Sunday. I have a hard time watching Sunday Night Baseball anymore. Because I miss Kurt Schilling, who was the best color analyst in baseball, but got kicked off the network because he retweeted a group that had claimed that radical Islam was responsible for a violent attack. Okay?
Right.
He just retweeted it. He didn't even say it. He just retweeted it. And they said, well, that's it did not violate whatever policy they had. For social media, and they kicked them off Sunday Night Baseball, and I have a hard time with. And in fact, I rarely watch Sunday Night Baseball anymore. They bring Kurt Schilling back tomorrow. I'm back on full board. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I'm the only one that feels that, but there's got
to
be others.
So Pitaro said basically they need clarity. They wanted just to bring clarity to their audience that we will change the direction of how we approach sports. So we'll see what happens. I mean, that's good news. I want to watch sports for sports.
Yeah, and let's go here. I don't want to watch Sunday Night Football and have Bob Costas go on an anti-gun rant for 15 minutes during halftime. That happened, you know.
Yeah.
So I don't need to hear that when I'm watching sports.
Right.
Give me sports.
Agreed. Sorry, I had to digress just because you
mentioned ESPN. That's not a digression.
So, anyway,
that as progression,
Absolutely. So let's talk hockey. Sharks had a huge game on Sunday at home. I mean, not the Sharks. Let me rephrase that. The Blues had a huge game against the Sharks. They beat them in San Jose 5-0. Tonight will be the determining game whether or not, if Blues can win this, they will move on to play the Boston Bruins in the Stanley Cup. And I'm so excited. I was so excited about that game.
Yeah, Blues at home should be.
Sorry.
They're heavy favorites. They're heavy favorites, and the Sharks are without a couple other top players, including Joe Pavelski not playing today.
So is that confirmed that he's not playing? Because there were about five of their top players that were injured.
Yeah, they got a lot of guys out. They not only got beat badly in that game, they got beaten up in that game. And remember last week we had Gary Bettman, and we had commissioner of the NHL on here,
yep.
My impersonation
yes,
of him.
Yes, that was a very good impersonation.
And he said at that time, yes, that he did not want the Sharks to win because it would put an asterisk next to it was my version of him.
It's terrible.
And it is true. This is as it should go right now. Blues in Boston.
Blues in Boston. That would be a great series. And other players for the Sharks, it was Eric Carlson, defenseman that got injured.
And Carlson, you're talking about the best defensive player in the league, the best defensive scorer. Yes, and having Hurdle out is another big loss for them.
Mm-hmm.
So they're right now the Sharks are plus 170, you know, and the Blues minus 150, 160. There's no way I'd bet the Sharks tonight. And you know, and Martin Jones after that last game, their goalkeeper, the Sharks goalkeeper. He got rattled in that game,
mm-hmm.
and when he gets rattled, we saw here with the Knights.
He just kind of tanks.
Yeah, a couple of games where he got tanked, where he had a difficult time. So I think he's in that situation. So unless he stands on his head to stop shots, then it's going to be Blues and Bruins. So that's what the NHL wants. That's what I would like to see at this point. It'd be a fun series.
I wish it was that easy. You never know. I know there's politics involved in the game, but you just don't know.
Then we go back to politics and sports.
Sorry, but there is, right? I mean, I really think sometimes. I know in football there is.
Yes.
I'm not talking about that. It's just sometimes you just don't know what the outcome is. You like to say this is what it would ideally is to be a great Stanley Cup, but you never know.
No, I think it will be a great Stanley Cup. I'm already counting it in my head, so it better happen as the Boston Bruins against the St. Louis Blues.
Mm-hmm.
In that case, Blues would be an easy team to be able to root for. They've never won a Stanley Cup, so it would be fun to see. They played in the finals before, but that was in 67 when they first came into the league, and they were forced to as one of the eight expansion teams to play in the finals is the way that the format was set up. So they only got there by default in the past. So this will be their first, I'll say, real trip to the finals without it being mandated by the NHL that as an expansion team they go in.
So from hockey to the NFL, let's talk a little NFL. A lot of stuff going on right now. There was
some
major key it's off season, but like I said, there's always drama in the NFL. Ndamukong Suh was just picked up, your defensive lineman just picked up by the Tampa Bay Buccaneers for 1 year.
Okay.
That's a pretty good addition.
Down to Florida.
So, Miami. And Tampa Bay. The Bucks released Gerald McCoy after 9 seasons, partially because of his $13 million salary. So, we'll see where he goes or where he lands. I know that there's conversations right now with the Patriots, possibly taking him on. Maybe the Browns would love to have him so he could play with Myles Garrett. You know, some good players there.
Yeah, I'm back on the Sue thing. Loses the Rams, losing him. Okay, that's fine. Their defensive line is still in good shape. Aaron Donald's best in the league right there. They got some other guys to be able to help him out. Sue wasn't as much of a factor
mm-hmm.
as we thought he would be. They needed to shore up their linebacker core a little bit, and they've got Clay Matthews helping them with that this year, so that I'm looking forward to seeing what he can do, how much he has left in him. But it'll just be fun to see Clay Matthews with his hair flying out of his helmet, LA Rams helmet instead of the Packers helmet.
I love
it. It'll look so much better on him.
He's such a great player. Julian Edelman of the New England Patriots is finalizing a 2-year, $18 million contract extension, which might allow him to finish his career in New England. He's so fabulous. He's just got such energy. You're not a Patriots fan, I know.
I don't dislike the Patriots. You're right, I'm not a Patriot fan. I'm a Rams fan. I don't dislike the Patriots.
You're just tired of them.
I'm not even tired. I like teams that succeed and do well. So if you're going to succeed and do well and win, I just wish the Rams would have been able to get some offense going and beat them last year. But that being said, he was the key to that game. He was Edelman, and the Rams missing Cooper Kupp on offense mm-hmm. was that type of player who would have changed that game around. But he was injured. He'd been injured for a good part of the season, so it wasn't like shocking that he was out for that game. But that being said, Cooper Kupp back this year, and looking forward to that. Edelman deserves that money, and he's he'll spend half of that in razor blades. Because he is shaving his beard now.
Oh, my goodness.
He shaved it. I don't know if he's going to get a girl in during the season.
Vic will be his sponsor.
Yeah,
for sure.
I saw a shot of him recently, and he shaved it. He's clean shaven.
Well, another huge loss for the Washington Redskins. Reuben Foster, former 49ers, is out with a torn ACL for the season. You know, they started OTAs yesterday, so they carted him off the field. The Patriots re-signed defensive tackle Danny Shelton, and who knows what LA Rams Todd Gurley. Are we excited about him? I mean, is he going to be healthy?
Well, there's no reason for him not to be. I mean, his Rams haven't even really acknowledged that it was a knee problem, but everybody pretty much knows that, mm-hmm. that late in the season it was him. It was he had done too much. He was the workhorse running back, and they just wore him down. Okay, Rams, lesson here, okay? Mm-hmm. You know, don't let the guy play, you know, 60 minutes a game. Set him down for a while. Don't let him, especially late in the season, don't be running him ragged, and his knees just, he had nothing left in him. You know, C.J. Anderson came on, did very well, and the Rams was happy to see that. Thank you, Raiders. They've got to have a healthy Todd Gurley and have to pace him. Pace Todd Gurley. And Sean McVay will do that.
Sean McVay is awesome. Let's talk quarterbacks for a little bit in the NFL. I want to talk about Tanya's top five quarterbacks.
Okay.
So, we're going to break it down. We're looking at the AFC. I'm thinking Ben Roethlisberger is going to have another good year. Hey, he's getting up there in age. He's my number five. I like Aaron Rodgers. Is back, hopefully healthy again this year. They've got some new management.
Okay.
He's so stellar when he's on his game. He had a tough one last year.
Yeah.
Patrick Mahomes, obviously.
Okay,
right now, one of the best quarterbacks in the league. Drew Brees and Tom Brady. What do you think of my picks?
Where's Jared Goff in there, by the way? The Rams had the best offense in the NFL last year.
These are my top five.
I guess.
Jared Goff, though, had a stellar year, but this is kind of what I'm looking at.
So I'd say other than that, you're in pretty good shape. You put Brady's the king of the
He's
hill until
there.
Somebody can knock him off. That's the way the game is played. You're the king of the hill, and nobody has been able to knock him off. So it is absolutely, I don't care. He's what now? He's 450 years old? So let him continue at how old he is and just continue. It just keeps going, man.
It's like the Energized Bunny.
Keeps
going.
Okay, Saints and the Rams play this year, by the way.
That's going to be a huge game.
That will be because of what happened last year in the call that the refs missed. And I'm talking about the Saints penalty when they made it on the Rams when they were offsides, one big call in the game. Now, everybody else thinks it was that pass interference call, but I forget that. There was a call earlier in the game that they missed horribly against the Saints. Nobody wants to talk about that.
I agree with you on that.
So it was just the timing of that. That play. That being said, yes, it would. That'll be fun. Drew Brees, hard not to go with number nine. Okay, for the Saints there, but I would put Jared Goff in the number two spot and move everybody down and take Roethlisberger out of there. Yeah, Mahomes. Boy, Kansas City is having a rough time keeping some of their players right now.
That's the problem.
Yeah, I mean they got to mind themselves. How about that? That's an old British phrase. Mind yourself.
And I always wonder, too. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you, Ron. I always wonder if other teams will get his number this year. First year out, it was sort of like Russell Wilson the first year. Russell's still stellar as a quarterback. But once he started running those plays, those other teams got, they caught on real quick. You know, and I wonder if that will happen to Mr. Mahomes in Kansas City. You never know. He's a great quarterback. He's a strong, you know, he's got a strong pass, but
yes.
Good in the pocket.
Yeah, he can go deep. The dude can bring it. It's mm-hmm. fun to watch him. One of the plays he made this year when he threw the ball with his right hand, with his left hand rather, when he was being, his left hand was being stopped and grabbed and had to throw with his opposite hand there, his left hand, his right hand was being held. And it was phenomenal. It was one of the great plays in the NFL this past season. And he had a lot of them. He had a lot of the great plays in the NFL.
Yeah, he did.
This past season.
It'll be interesting to see Kyler Murray this year. And very exciting for 49er fans to see Jimmy Garoppolo throwing again at OTAs.
Not to me, it's not.
I'm very excited.
Not as an NFC West fan. I'm not at all excited to see Jimmy Garoppolo.
I think you guys are stacked in all positions. I don't think you have too much to worry about. We might give you a little competition.
We'll see. It'll step it up, certainly. And he's got one of the best tight ends in the business to be able to throw the ball to. Just
George Kittle.
Just really love everything this guy brings in the game. Uh-huh. If there was one player that I could say in the NFL that I'd like for the Rams to steal
it's
from
George.
Another team, it would be George Kittle. If you haven't had that sort of tight end, I think he's going to be a star for years and years. Very fast, very good. They use him like a wide receiver.
They do.
And he is a tight end size. He's that big and that strong. But he's fast enough to be like a whiteout, and that's tough for those DBs that are 5'9" to be able to stop him coming at you 6'4" and running with that sort of speed. You can't do it. So you're right with Garoppolo throwing to him, and that was one thing with him not playing last year for the Niners that they missed. This guy's gonna say will be fun to
It'll
watch.
It'll be a good.
It'll be interesting to watch.
I love our rivalry. It's a great rivalry. It really is.
Northern California. So there's still people who live in Northern California, then, is what you're saying. So there is that part of the state still
heck
exists?
Yes. You think not?
No, when you think of California, what do you think of? California, what do you think? You think
beaches and palm trees?
High rent prices.
High taxes.
High taxes.
But
that.
It is.
The sun, the fun, Disneyland, Hollywood.
That's Southern Cal.
The beach. Oh, you think of everything in Southern California. No, you don't think of the redwoods.
California is beautiful, but you're right.
The homeless problem in San Francisco.
You're right.
You know,
anyway. All right. Well, we've got a lot more coming up after the break. Stay with us because Jim Gemma of the Aviators will be joining us after a few minutes.
Oh, sorry, what'd you say? That's literally all I think about.
You are so good. You know what, can you imagine, like,
So so we'll get Jim, can he?
Okay, so we might have to do kind of a pull the same thing as last week. We might have a last little short break.
What happened? Oh, yeah.
So, what we'll do is we'll talk a little baseball. What baseball games? I know I've got some scores from last night.
Is there a show the Dodgers are playing down in Tampa?
Dodgers are in Tampa.
So, real quick. Basically, regardless of him, you could technically go all the way to 55, give or take, if you want. If it ends up like that, and we don't have to take another break.
And then we just take the 5 minute,
Yeah, and then that's it. Like, the show just ends then. Or, we have 1 minute now. If you do want to take a break, that's fine. Just try to, if you decide to, just try not to take it too close to, like, 55, because then it's, then we'll
come. We'll go 54.
Oh,
I see what you mean.
Meaning, like, before the... Yeah, like, if we get to, like, 50, we might as well just go to 55 and just kill the show. Like,
okay. Can we stretch?
Which is a good thing. We don't have to.
Can we stretch,
Ron?
30 seconds. So, in other words, he may not be able to call.
I'm hoping Jim will call in right at 4:40.
Okay, I'll keep an eye on, let you know as soon as...
You want to talk baseball a little bit more? Salt Lake lead is sliced to 9-6. I'll talk a little bit of Major League Baseball. Salt Lake wins the game
9-6. And the Salt Lake Bees have to be thrilled. All right, here we go. So yeah, just let me know. Just, if you want to take a break at some point, just be like, Just threaten me. Ready? Oh yeah, you're always ready.
I love this. Welcome back to Vegas Sports Girl. And I love this video. This was such a cool
sports
video. Do you remember this?
Oh, I don't remember the video.
I can't remember her name, but that was such a great tune. I love it. Anyway, welcome back to Vegas Sports Girl.
I want to sing when it kicks in.
I know.
But
you just want to listen to it?
Yeah.
It's amazing. It's amazing. This
I
is
made
good.
Up my mind.
I just imagine.
Wasting no more time. Here I go again.
Okay, let's go now.
I just imagine you with your guitar, Ron, and that photo with the long hair. Joining us on the phone, we've got a lot of baseball news we're going to get to, but most and more importantly, we've got the star, in my opinion, of the Aviators joining us online. Jim, Gemma, are you there?
Do you have Jorge Mateo coming on today? I'm definitely not the star, but I appreciate you having me on the show today.
Jim, how are you, my friend? You're home for a week, yes?
Yes, team came in from Salt Lake City this morning, just a five-game road trip over the weekend. Not the best weather in Utah, but it's just a quick four-game homestand, actually, tonight through Friday against the Albuquerque Isotopes, which is the AAA affiliate of the Colorado Rockies. So they're here through Friday, and we'll have our second fireworks show this Friday night to cap off the homestand.
Can I go to that fireworks show, Jim?
Yeah, just
I'm gonna call you tomorrow.
What you need.
Special pass.
Just gonna hook you up, as they say.
So what should we expect this week?
Well, right now the team, started the season really well, but right now they're 24-21. So right now, the story of the PCL South Division is El Paso, AAA affiliate of the Padres. They're 29-15. So they're once again leading the our division. They've won the division the last 4 years. So hopefully the team can rebound here from this quick homestand, because they go right back out for a nine-game road trip starting Saturday in Reno.
Outstanding. So, Jim, let me ask you this. What are you having most fun with about this team? Are you getting a break? Any time between this busy, crazy schedule?
Well, baseball is a weird. They did have two rainouts, which is very unusual on Thursday and Friday, but there's not another day off now until June 3rd, I should say, Monday. But right now the team needs to come back and get in a better situation playing-wise, and the crowds have been great here. You know, the story so far has been Las Vegas leads all of AAA baseball in total attendance and average. They're averaging 9,617 at Las Vegas ballpark. So that's really the big story here the first 6 weeks.
Congratulations, Jim. That's such a testament to you and your team. Just doing marketing it right, and you've got a great followership. That's awesome.
No, it's great. The Las Vegas ballpark's a great venue. It's a great location, and we really thank the fans for all of their support. This week the weather's kind of weird, but we know the triple digits are right behind us, so they're coming at some point.
It's a fun ballpark, Jim. I had high expectations for this ballpark when I heard the first plans come out, but boy, let me tell you, but you guys have met and exceeded those. And it's just a fun ballpark. I go out there, interact with a lot of the fans out there. I've heard nothing but great things. I'm trying to think of a criticism. I can't. Okay, concession prices are too high, but you can say that in every ballpark. But the food is very good. the food is still very good out there. And so that part of it, you're going to get that. But I'll tell you, it's just been fun to see what this ballpark has meant for this community. And I think you feel the same way, that it's not just a great place to go watch baseball, but a great place for the community to come together, meet, gather, and hang out. Would you agree?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Our ownership group, Howard Hughes Corporation, did a fabulous job on Penta that built the place. The construction workers were incredible. I mean, you can't find a better location than this. The lower bowl is the best. You can go all the way around. It's 360. And, concession prices, I go to the movies a lot, go to concerts a lot. The prices are fine. when you want to go get a vodka and cranberry at one of these concerts, it's $14 to $18 and stuff like that. When you go to Regal Cinemas, and it's just the nature of the beast now. It's still, the prices are great. We have free parking, and it's a great atmosphere, like you said.
And that's a great point. Because of your complimentary parking, your ticket prices are reasonable, you're able to take a lot, all your family. Hey, why not? Concessions, there should be no question there. Go buy your lots of food.
It's good food. It is good. Like I said, it is very good food there. And you just get regular hot dogs if you want, if that's your thing, and popcorn and enjoy that, and peanuts. Or you can go gourmet out there. There's even a Capriati's out there if you like to go.
Ooh, nice.
With the Bobby and have that sort of stuff. So that's Jim, I got to mention this. The Burnt In Burritos out there in center field. Rockstar food out there in center field. There's a Mexican place there that has burnt. Have you tried those yet? Have you tried the Burnt In Burritos out there?
You know, I'm kind of anchored up here in the press box. I have walked around the lower bowl. There's a lot of food options, to say the least. I've heard a lot of good things about that area you just described. So, again, you can have regular ballpark food or the upgrade a little bit, or you know, there's some fine eateries around in downtown Summerlin too. Again, the mixed use development here is really great. Probably the best setup here in all minor league baseball.
Hey Jim, question for you: are people in the pool?
That is the backside of this schedule. We have triple digits. The pool is getting booked fast.
Wow.
June, July, and August. That'll be the place to be. So far, yeah, we've had some good crowds at the pool, especially for the Sunday games.
Awesome. Tanya wants her spot in the pool.
I do.
She's telling me. What do you think, Jimmy?
You're in.
You good with that?
I'm in. Okay. I want my recliner. I want to lay out.
You've got a game, obviously, tonight. Wednesday, you got Bark on the Berm, so bring the puppies out there and have a good time out there. The Wag Your Tail Wednesday and Bark on the Berm. Fireworks on Friday. Anything else this week that we need to know about with this quickie four-game homestand?
Well, yeah, since it's there for the, you know, we're talking about the concession prices, we have $2 beer nights on Thursday.
Okay.
That's nice. That we've kind of kept that tradition. A lot of minor league teams do the $2 Thursday nights. So, yeah, we have $2 beer night. But, again, the next firework installment will be this Friday in the finale of the homestand. All games at 7:05 tonight through Friday. I really appreciate you having me on.
Awesome. Thanks so much for joining us, Jim. And I will see you this week, okay?
Sounds great. Thank you.
All right.
Thanks,
bye-bye.
Jimmy.
All right. Thanks, Ron.
See ya.
Such a good guy.
He's been with the 51s and the Stars, and so he's been with that franchise for a long time.
Thanks,
he has, and just been a great guy for sports here in Vegas. Mm-hmm. Just been able to promote sports, work with media, and we can be crusty and hard to work with at times. So that's been Jimmy's job, is to do that, and he's the best.
That's an interesting description.
I am stealing that for sure.
We can be crusty.
I work with a lot of crusty people.
Can't we?
Crusty.
No, here's what bothers me about media people a little bit. We got one of the funnest jobs on the planet. Okay, we get to sit in front of a mic and talk, go to sporting events for free. There's usually free food at these things, and you still find a lot of ornery, and that's nice word, crusty. I could even give a worse word, but I won't because it's going to get beeped here on the radio. Of people that are unhappy in the media and the sports media, and I sit there and go, "Are you kidding? Are you kidding me? Look what you get to do, and look what you have. Why do
it's
you have,
the best."
We'll sit there at major events, and I'll hear media people, "This sucks. I can't believe it. We don't have better seats."
Yep.
How much you pay for the? Okay with the seats? You know, you didn't pay for them.
You're
right?
Absolutely correct.
Yeah, but you know what? You see the food in the press room? I did see the food in the press room, and I ate some of it. It was good. No. And I'm not going to name names because a lot of them are friends of mine. But it is.
Are they friends?
No, it exists.
No, it's true.
It exists. You're right. It's a complacency, I guess you can call it that.
I get the attitude. You sit in an air conditioned room and sit in front of a microphone right here and talk, and then go to the sporting events for free. And you're on the pulse of sports, and you're there. And I don't know. Maybe it's okay. Now I've gone off in a different direction with you, Tanya. Here, you didn't expect me to go here,
right.
But maybe it's just generally in life that you're gonna find some people that are unhappy and happy no matter what they're doing, type of thing. I think back on what I've done for a job in my life: pumping gas, driving a tow truck in Salt Lake City in the snow, pouring concrete, tarring roofs. Doing carpentry work in homes and different. Okay, what I've done for employment over the years have been some pretty difficult things and backbreaking stuff, and this ain't nothing, like that.
You're right.
Is fun stuff that I've gotten to do for the last, how many years in Vegas? I've got here 34, 35 years in Vegas that I've just to do fun stuff here. Okay.
Well,
that
we
enjoy.
Met. We met back in 2000
yes.
when we hosted Monday Night Quarterback together.
We had fun with that show.
That was fun. That was a blast. You can't go wrong with sports. You're with good people. I mean, it's very exciting. So
yes, you should. If there's something wrong. If you're not having fun with it, you're doing something wrong. But like I said, Ari's nodding his head going, yeah, it's, but there are too many times with guys that I see that are just full of, and it's the same guys complaining all the time.
And there's a lot of young people that are ready and willing to snatch up those positions.
Oh, by the way, yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Speaking of baseball, we have a few scores last night, and I know that we've got some games going on tonight. But Red Sox beat the Blue Jays 12-2. A's beat the Indians 6-4. Mets over the Nationals 5-3. What games are going on tonight, Ron?
Dodgers playing at Tampa Bay. Clayton Kershaw on the mound. Dodgers up 1-0 early on in that one. Tampa's a pretty good team this year. Dodgers obviously leading the West. What Jim mentioned there was sort of interesting. I want to cap on that a little bit. Is he's talking about the Padres coming here with the Isotopes. That's the Padres AAA farm team now is Albuquerque
mm-hmm.
that's coming here. Watch out for the Padres. I'm telling you, this is a good young baseball team. They picked up Manny Machado in the offseason, the former Dodger player, former Orioles shortstop. Watch out. If their pitching comes around and they have good young what is leading them right now in the minors is their pitching. They've got a good young pitching staff. When those pitchers are ready to come up to the Padres, San Diego's going to have a ball club. Maybe not this year,
mm-hmm.
but next year or the year after, the
couple
Padres
years.
Are going to be real good, and they're going to challenge the Dodgers in the National League West. And so you get to see some of those guys that are here with the Padres in town over the next 4 days. And, of course, the A's, the AAA farm team, the Las Vegas Aviators are the AAA farm team for the Oakland A's. So
that's awesome.
And the A's, that's a good step for them to be able to have a West Coast team as good as the Oakland A's are. It really fits for this team.
It's exciting, especially. And is it difficult when you go and play for a minor team to make that team? I mean, there's so much competition with baseball players, right? I mean.
Oh, yeah, of course. Yes, and you've got how many levels? You start with rookie league,
right.
And then you go to Class A, Double A, and Triple A. And sometimes there's multiple rookie league and Class A teams. So you're talking about the minor. The system set up for baseball is unique, and it serves baseball very well. It's been said, and I would not disagree with this, I'm going to agree with this, is that in all of those levels of baseball, the closest, the narrowest margin is between the major leagues and AAA.
I see.
Is where
mm-hmm.
there is a gap between AA and AAA, the gap between single A, and certainly a gap between rookie and single A, and all that sort of stuff. Yeah, the narrowest margin is that margin between the majors and AAA. They're right there.
That's very interesting. I always wondered that because
yeah.
I've had friends that played in the minors and hoped to make it to the majors, but, you know, how competitive is that? I know in the NFL it's very competitive, in the NBA, but I think all sports in the pro arena is pretty tough.
It's tough to get to the show.
Yeah, it is. Other Major League Baseball news, the Mariners trade Anthony Swarzak to the Braves. Dodgers pitcher, you know this, Julio?
Yes.
Urias is to be reinstated.
Yeah, he got in an argument with his girlfriend or his wife, I think girlfriend, in a parking lot. And witnesses say that he shoved her to the ground. You can never, ever in a million years condone anything close
sure.
to that. Immediately, the Dodgers and baseball took him off the team. They've done an investigation. I don't know everything that they found out. What they say happened here and what they've done, but they're talking about reinstating him. So they must have found that it either wasn't as serious. I don't know what they've done, so I'm not going to try to say. But they are going. He's a good young pitcher for the Dodgers. Okay, he is that. They need him.
All right. I want to thank our sponsors, Finley Volvo and the Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Check us out on VegasSportsGirl.com. Like us, share us on social media. Ron, you going to head out to the baseball field this week?
I am going to head out. Oh, yeah, well, absolutely. I'm going to go do some stories out there. So going to take my camera out, do some stories, and have some fun. The suites out there are real nice, too, by the way. And I haven't talked about those a whole lot, but they've got some great suites out there. Club section, all sorts of fun places to go and watch baseball out there. It doesn't get old to me to go watch baseball out at that
right.
ballpark. And it's new, so you can't at this point. But years down the road, I still see myself going in there, smiling, having a good time, and enjoying the ballpark. It's in my neighborhood, so that part I like about it. And even if you live in Henderson, Tanya,
it's
you live in Henderson,
you
okay?
Take the 215 all the way around.
Zip right up and you're there.
Yep. This is a great time right now, too, if you're golfers. Good time to get out on the golf course. It's beautiful right now, with the exception of the wind. But once that goes away, it's a nice time. A lot of things to do here in Las Vegas. I know that we were talking earlier, prior to the show, group of us, about the draft coming again in 2020 for the NFL. So that's exciting.
I'm so excited. It is a year from now, so we have a little time to gear up. But that will come quicker than what we know. It will happen.
All right. Well, stay tuned to Vegas Sports Girl. Check us out on all social media. Like and share us. We will be back next Tuesday at 4 p.m. Go watch that basketball game tonight and hockey game. And have a wonderful night. Thanks for joining us.